back to our NIVS Home School. Hope you are fine at home. This is Shilbi Shaha, Assistant Teacher of English, National Ideal English Version School, Morning Shift. Dear student, today I am going to take your home science class for the student of class 6. Our today's topic is chapter 9. Today we will discuss this chapter and I will provide some creative question from this chapter in next class. So student, now let's get started our class. Our today's chapter 9, nutritional value of food. So student, this is a big chapter. We have already underlined some important lines that are very important for your MCQ and creative questions. So we will read this underlined sentence basically. Now lesson 1, rice and wheat. Food value of rice. Rice is the main grain type food of Bangladesh. Basically there are two types of rice available there. These are boiled rice and not boiled rice. In addition, there are parallel husked rice and rice husked in mills. In any kind of rice, there is almost same quantity of food energy. So rice is the main source of carbohydrate. So student, you know, rice is the main source of carbohydrate. There are given two pictures, parallel husked rice and white and golden rice. And food value of rice at a glance. So main food element, carbohydrate. So carbohydrate is the main food element of rice. And other mentionable food elements, protein, thiamine, riboflavin, niacin. So other than rice, fried rice, that means muri, jeera and puffed rice can also be made from paddy. The food value of this food is almost same as rice. Now the second point, nutritional value of wheat. Wheat is the second food crop of Bangladesh. You know, rice is the first and wheat is the second food crop of Bangladesh. Wheat. This is a picture about wheat. Almost the same amount of food energy can be obtained from wheat compared to rice. Now food value of wheat as a class. Main food element, it is also carbohydrate. And other mentionable food elements, protein, thiamine, riboflavin, niacin, vitamin E. There are two kinds of coarse flours available in market now. White flour and brown flour. White flour does not include the coverings of wheat. On the contrary, brown flour includes the coverings. So brown flour is beneficial to health. Now lesson 2, fish and meat. Food value of fish. Fish is a very good source of animal protein. There are fat and minerals in fish too. Hilsa, shing, pangash, koi, shoi puti, etc. have more fat. Fishes with more fat are tastier as well as good in food energy. Now, food value of fish at a glance. Main food value of fish is protein and other mentionable food elements. Fat, vitamin A, D and E, calcium, phosphorus and iron. Dried fish is very popular in some regions of Bangladesh. Dried fish contains protein 2 and 3 times more than that in fresh fish. Besides, calcium and phosphorus are also much higher in quantities in dried fish. So sea fishes have iodine. From the oil extracted of livers of codfish and shark, we get enough vitamin A and D. Now nutritional value of meat. We take the fishy proteins of cow, bull, goat, sheep, duck, hen and other animals and birds that meat. In our country, chicken is also as popular as beef and mutton. And the food energy of meat depends on its quantity of fat. Meat is a good source of iron and phosphorus. Liver is a good source of iron and vitamin A. Calcium is mainly obtained from bone. Calcium is very less in boneless meat. Now pulse, milk and egg. Various kinds of pulses here. Spout of pulses, nutritional value of pulses. Mung, lentil, tuna, khesari, mashkolai, arhor are a pulse type of food. And pulses contains fat significantly less with more of carbohydrates. To meet the need of protein, pulses can be taken instead of fish and meat. Pulses are very good sources of thiamine, riboflavin and niacin. So now lesson nutritional value of eggs. Among the protein type food, egg is the best. All the elements necessary for adequate and all round development of a human body are present in eggs. Eggs contain significant quantities of proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. And now egg protein is of good quality and 100% of it is beneficial for health. The eggs of hen, duck, goose and quail birds are commonly consumed as food in our country. According to the size of the eggs, the nutritional value varies. Nutritional value of milk. Milk is an ideal food which is naturally produced. Milk contains all the nutrients, in contains 90% of water. Quality of milk protein is very high. The quantity of riboflavin is much in vitamins of milk. Milk contains calcium, phosphorus in a large scale, which help the formation of bones. Now listen, for vegetable and fruit. Food values of vegetables and fruits. Vegetables and fruits comprise an essential part of daily diet. Vegetables and fruits contain mainly carbohydrates, vitamins, minerals and water. As the fruits and vegetables contain abundant vitamins and minerals, this cater to the need of natural nutrition of the body, resist the body from diseases and malnutrition. To stay healthy, it is essential to keep fruit and vegetable in our daily diet. So if we want to stay healthy life, if you want to stay a healthy life, it is essential to keep fruit and vegetable in our daily diet. Cauliflower, green chili, capsicum, cabbage, broccoli and tomato are the good sources of vitamin C. Broccoli provides a good source of calcium. Beans and seed type vegetables are good sources of proteins and vitamins. Sweet fruits contain more carbohydrates than green fruits. Fresh fruits contain phosphorus and iron and small quantities of calcium. Juicy fruits meet the need of water. In our country, fruits of various tastes are available during various seasons. These seasonal fruits are tastier and more nutritious in their respective seasons. For good health, hence, it is necessary to have the seasonal fruits regularly. Now, lesson 5, nuts, oils and ghee. Nutritional value of nuts. Peanut is the most common nut which grow in significant quantities in Bangladesh. And peanuts comprise a good source of phosphorus, iron and calcium are there in little amount. Besides, manganese, potassium, copper, zinc among other minerals are also in peanuts. These are tasty as well as very nutritious and hence are liked by all. And nutritional values of oil. Edible oils are available from plants. Edible oils are mainly used in cooking in mustard, sesame, sunflower, peanut, soybean, cotton seed, and in corns there is enough fat. So oil can be produced from these seeds. Among all the food, most of the heat energy is available oils. So friend, you have to read this chapter thoroughly because you can get MCQ question and creative questions from this chapter. So, friend, stay well and keep practicing at home. See you next class.